I have had it with these motherfucking
studios
on this motherfucking
video.
Warning, if you don't like spoilers, do not watch the video.
All right, we're down to the last pile. Hey there, guys. This is a bad time as I'm just reorganizing my movie collection, and, yeah, I have nothing to review this month, so, see you later.
Where the hell am I going to put all these movies?
Guys, I said see you later. Bye-bye. Okay, I get it. You want me to review something? That's fine. I'll just look through this pile, see what I've got to review here. I mean, we got Moonwalker, Barnyard, Meet the Spartans. Oh, Jesus Christ! Frankly, I hate that movie. Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. You know, I haven't seen this movie in a very long time. I have vague memories of seeing the film in theaters with my parents. We actually had to go to a different showing because the only seats available were in the front row. I distinctly remember being mesmerized by the film, mostly The Factory. The only film that I would have found better was Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, starring Gene Wilder. Even so, I loved this new version so much, I got the video game for the Xbox. It was alright.
You know what? Let's watch it. Not the worst thing I've done. Alright. Let's give this movie a shot.
And one thing was absolutely certain. Life had never been sweeter.
Wow! Just wow! You know, I didn't know this until today, but my childhood sucked! What? Wait, scratch that, reverse it. Parts of my childhood sucked. I mean, I saw both this movie and Batman Begins in theaters that same year. So, I'd actually say my childhood was pretty balanced. Still though, this is a bad movie. Look, I know this film has its fans, but I'm not really one of them. So, without further ado, let's take a look at Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Charlie Bucket is a young boy whose family is struggling financially. He dreams of one day being able to go into the Wonka Candy Factory, owned by Willy Wonka. Then one day, Willy announces via flyer that 5 lucky children will actually be allowed into the factory for a grand tour. It also mentions how one lucky child will get a special prize beyond their imagination. In order to enter the factory, each kid needs a golden ticket. As the days go on, 4 random kids find their tickets. Charlie, however, doesn't have such luck. Once he hears that some Russian kid found the final ticket, he loses all hope. He decides to buy himself a Wonka bar with some money he found on the street. As he opens the candy, he sees that he found the last golden ticket. Overjoyed, he runs home and shows the ticket to his Grandpa Joe. Because a guardian has to go with Charlie, Grandpa Joe is chosen since he used to work for Willy Wonka. The next day, all legitimate ticket winners and their guardians are waiting at the gates to enter. After passing through the gates, a little show is performed to introduce Willy Wonka. But when it ends, Willy is clearly not on stage. That's because he was watching the show. After an awkward introduction,
"Good morning, Starshine."
He takes everyone inside and shows them the candy room. As everyone has a good time, one of the kids, Augustus Gloop, eats his way through the room. As he eats some of the candy grass, he falls into the chocolate river and gets sucked up by a pipe. While Augustus' mother panics, Willy's workers, the Oompa Loompas, do a song and dance. After the song, Mrs. Gloop is escorted to the fudge room and the tour continues. Question is, who's next? Which child is going to leave? Who will be the grand prize winner? Do I have to go over the film's plot?
If you like what you are seeing, make sure to leave a like. If you want more content, then make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get all the latest updates. Thank you very much, and enjoy.
If there's anything positive I can say about this film, it's that the set design is wonderful. It's the one thing that makes Tim Burton stand out in a good way. He always gives his films a unique look. His visuals are almost always stunning. The factory in this film is whimsical and strange, looking like no other factory in the world. It's also colorful and exciting, most of the time. Outside of the factory, the film's world is almost extraordinary. I even like the design of the bucket house. The little details in the house make it feel lived in, like it actually has a family living there. The film's cinematography also plays a part in the visual style. It's smooth and simple, even when moving. Grandpa George is my favorite character, and it's not just the fact he speaks for the audience, but it's also the fact that he's able to convince Charlie to go to the factory. There will be more on that later. Grandpa Joe is pretty good. He is a kind man with endless enthusiasm, always trying to cheer Charlie up. And while I think it's interesting, the fact that he worked for Willy Wonka is kind of pointless, since it barely plays into the plot. Well, outside giving the screenwriter a way to dump exposition.
Well, there's always the chance they decided not to light it today.
My biggest complaint with the film is Johnny Depp's portrayal of Willy Wonka. I know I'm not the first one to say this, but Depp's version of Wonka reminds me of a bizarro version of Michael Jackson. Sure, Michael may have had some unusual things, but at least it came from him, not a cue card. And yes, he had issues with his father, but they were much more severe than weird braces and not being able to eat candy. Well, then again, Joe Jackson never moved an entire house before, or kept every newspaper clipping of his son's achievements. But there's one thing that both Michael Jackson and Willy Wonka share. Both live in secluded worlds built by their own success. With Michael, it was Thriller, with Willy, it was candy. The problem with Depp's version of Wonka is that it's just too strange for this character. Willy Wonka is supposed to be a whimsical tour guide who you're not too sure you can trust. Well, I'm not sure if the Wonka from the books was like that. I know the Wonka from the original film is, and that's the version of Wonka that this film should have had. Well, I think Johnny Depp could have done something closer to Gene Wilder. I do feel like there are better choices for the role.
Here are the top 5 Willy Wonka choices that would have been better than Johnny Depp. In no particular order. Number 5, Prince. He's short, weird, and can sing. Maybe with some practice, he could have been a good actor.
Fuck off!
Number 4, Alan Cumming. When I rewatched the first Spy Kids, I couldn't help but get Willy Wonka vibes from Floop. Plus, he sings. Number 3, David Bowie. Imagine Bowie singing Pure Imagination. Yeah, it's great. Oh, and hey, he could also act too. Number 2, Hugh Jackman. He's Wolverine, he's Gaston, he's Peter Allen, and number 1, Neil Patrick Harris. Thanks for watching, Matt Mojo. Next week, we'll show you the top 5 sexiest staircases in anime.
The Willy Wonka song is obnoxious. It makes me want to bash my head against a wall. I think it comes down to 2 things. 1, the irritating vocals. Now, Sir Captain Daniel Elfman, I have no idea what you were going for, but it doesn't work. Actually, now that I think about it, there is no second thing. Willy Wonka's backstory feels tacked onto the film. Do we really need to know how he became a chocolatier? The original film didn't have some silly origin story for their Wonka, and he was a compelling and charming character. Then again, he was played by Gene Wilder, one of Mel Brooks' greatest collaborators, so it's easy to see why his version of Wonka was so great. Honestly though, I feel bad for complaining about Willy's flashbacks. I mean, Mrs. Beauregard had a non-flashback earlier.
Get in the bag.
Me? Won't you get in the bag?
I'm getting in the bag.
I was gonna get in the bag.
Charlie Bucket is, well, boring. He isn't really given all that much to do. It's not Freddie Highmore's fault. The screenwriters just put too much of their focus on Willy Wonka in a film called Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Charlie as a character really has no arc to speak of. He doesn't change in any way by the end of the film. There's never any challenge for Charlie. In the original film, Charlie had a challenge in the form of Slugworth. This version doesn't have that. One last thing about Charlie, how dare he think of throwing the golden ticket away for money?
Television chocolate.
The music in this film is okay. The film's score by Danny Elfman fits the film's aesthetic. Even so, it's nothing special. There's also the Oompa Loompa songs, also written by Elfman. Well, at least the music is. The lyrics were written by the novel's author, Roald Dahl. I'll quickly go over each song, since each song covers a different era and genre of music. I'll start with my TV song, where the music reminds me of Elfman's days and his band Oingo Boingo.
Stop!
Sean, what brings you here?
I'm helping you analyze the music here. Do you really want a repeat of mage music? It's not like anybody knows what that is.
Alright, give us your thoughts on the music.
Fine, let me get out my notes. God damn it, Jerry! You fucking piece of...
The music in this movie has to be some of the most unimaginative and uninspired I've ever heard. Other than that cover of Africa done by Pitbull for Aquaman.
In which the movie was actually pretty good, by the way.
What made the original Willy Wonka soundtrack so great was the fact that it's simple, catchy, and consistent, which helps to make the music in that film way more memorable. What the hell do I remember in this movie? Nothing. Literally nothing. I had to force myself to listen to this shit again.
Well, this isn't my review, so here's a brief summary of the music. It fucking reeks of dog shit while being slathered in cat pee, mixed with dead possums and the tears from fat guys who are addicted to pancakes and Diet Coke. And possibly meth.
What's wrong with you?
Goodbye, then.
While I can respect the fact this film has its fans, I personally hate this movie. It mainly comes down to Johnny Depp's awful portrayal of Willy Wonka, that head-splitting song, and the film's interpretation of Charlie Bucket. While there are positives like Grandpa Joe, Grandpa George, and the set design, it can't save my opinion of this film. If you want to see a better version of the story, watch the 1971 film. It's well worth your time to see the original. Alright, well, review's done now. Well, thank you all for watching. I'm gonna decide what I'm gonna do next month. I'll see you guys around. I found what I'm gonna review next month. The entire Toy Story trilogy! Yeehaw!
I'm going to let go of the wall!
What?
Hang on a minute, lads. I've got a great...
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
Down there.
No, fuck. Stop. Stop. Stop.
Sean, what are you doing here?
I'm helping you analyze the music.
All right. Give us your interpretation on the music. Let me actually make sure I...
Fine, let me bring up my notes. God damn it! Fucking reeks of dog shit, covered in cat pee, mixed with dead possum, and tears of fat guys. I know this isn't my review, but here's a brief summary of the music. It's a fucking piece of dog shit, glittered in cat pee, fucking dead possums, and... Ugh! Mixed with dead possums and fat... Fuck! It fucking reeks of dog shit while being slathered in cat pee, being mixed with... Bee? It fucking reeks of dog pee, mixed with cat pee, slathered in dead possums. It fucking reeks of dog shit while being slathered to a addicted from pancakes and Diet Coke. And possibly meth. Or heroin, because it's cheap. Who are addicted to pancakes and Coke. Diet Coke. And maybe a little bit of meth. Okay, we'll do one more take of that.
What's wrong with you? Yeehaw! This better look good, or else I'm gonna be mad.
If you enjoy our content, then please consider supporting Some Film Snobs on Patreon. Thank you.